These are taxing times for both political leaders, but the opposition leader is trying to do it in style. Tony Abbott and Julia Gillard going head-to-head over the carbon tax. Today, the Prime Minister announced 9 out of 10 families will get help to deal with expenses created by the tax. Mr Abbott, though, is promising to scrap that tax and offer tax cuts. Ms Gillard wants him to explain how he'll pay for it.
You appear to not have any idea where the money's coming from. We'll give you some Treasury officers to cost your plan. Australians deserve better than slogans and generalities and figments of imagination in the public debate.
That's unlikely.
People will get all the details of the Coalition's policies in good time before the next election. But the point I make is that this government should stop using the Treasury as a political weapon.
Greens leader Bob Brown, meanwhile, is predicting the details of the carbon tax will be a powerful weapon against Mr Abbott's campaign. But he says those details won't be finalised for weeks. And he's predicting the tax will see the eventual demise of the coal industry.
That has to be the outcome. You know, the coal industry has to be replaced by renewables.
Meanwhile, the asylum seeker deal with Malaysia is once again in the spotlight. The opposition's Scott Morrison is visiting a detention centre tomorrow, but is already on the attack.
The practical challenges of ensuring that those who we send to Malaysia aren't arrested or aren't potentially taken to a police holding cell or a detention centre, to make it work on the ground is very difficult.
The government says the plan will go ahead. Lauren Pedersen, World News Australia.